Mr. Speaker, what this amendment does is develops a 2010-2011 budget for the state of Connecticut. Importantly, it is a no-tax increase budget that has a $37 million surplus in both 2010 and 2011. Mr. Speaker, what the bill also does is fully funds aid to municipality. It takes care of interest payments necessary for borrowing, makes very difficult cuts, as the governor has done. Mr. Speaker, I've been involved in many conversations with people throughout this building. I think everyone's aware that the state faces very difficult circumstances.
The public expects us to
do the business at hand, and we believe that includes passing a balanced budget. I believe this document balances the needs of the state of Connecticut against its ability to pay. This puts us in line with the CPEC agreement.
It also puts us in line.
Representative Fleischman, I guess that was you. For what purpose do you rise?
For a point of order, Mr. Speaker.
Please proceed, sir.
Mr. Speaker, I believe it was time for summarization of the amendment before us. I don't believe the remarks we were hearing represented summarization of the content of the amendment before us.
Mr. Speaker, this eliminates grants to the Citizens Election Fund. It also takes care of other adjustments from the 2009-10 budget. It does not close any parks, doesn't reduce rates to private providers. It doesn't reduce rates to the charter schools, maintains same funding for priority schools, as I said, same aid to state municipalities, no cuts to local and district health departments. We also don't cut Connecticut Independent College grants, and no cuts to aid to public colleges. Mr. Speaker, this also funds over the 2 years of the biennium aid to the dairy farmers in the amount of $10 million each year. To be administered by the Department of Agriculture. Mr. Speaker, I move adoption.
Representative Merrill, for what purpose do you rise?
Point of order, Mr. Speaker. Question whether this amendment is germane to the underlying bill.